and welcome back to my channel. I am back with a travel vlog this time, and we are going to Brighton, which is one of the most happening beachy places near London, and it is just a 1 hour train ride from London, so it's very convenient to go. So once you are done exploring all of London, you can go ahead and visit this place. I am going here for my Easter holidays and I will take you through with me. So yes, let's just begin the trip.
So just hop on to any train from London. They run every 10 to 15 minutes and it's just a 1 hour journey, and we've already arrived to our station. It is already crowded and it is a hot favorite destination amongst locals and tourists.
Hey guys, so I am in Brighton and the first thing that I have done after coming out from the station is get these things. They are the bus passes and they are valid for whole day for as much travel that I have to do on my bus. So yeah, just after getting out, you can do this at any of the stations. So yes, that's what I've done, and yes, we'll head to our accommodation and then we'll head to the Brighton City Tour and I'll take you along with me. So yeah, let's go.
Brighton is an ideal trip for a weekend, and this is where we are staying for 2 nights in an Airbnb which is very, very close to the beach. तो सबसे पहले होगी पेट पूजा, फिर ही कोई काम दूजा. और ब्राइटन में वेजिटेरियन प्लेसेस के बहुत ऑप्शंस मिलेंगे. अनलाइक द कॉमन बिलीफ कि बाहर नॉन वेज आइटम्स ज़्यादा मिलते हैं और वेजिटेरियन नहीं मिलता है, यहाँ पर बहुत वेजिटेरियन एंड वीगन ऑप्शंस है, सो यू नीड नॉट वरी अबाउट इट एट ऑल. सो डे वन वी डिसाइडेड टू एक्सप्लोर द सिटी साइड ऑफ ब्राइटन. तो हम उन सब छोटी छोटी स्ट्रीट्स में गए. दिस इज़ नॉर्थ लेन, जहाँ पर दोनों साइड बहुत सारी ईटरीज हैं, बहुत सारे एंटीक शॉप्स हैं, इवन फ्ली मार्केट्स ऑन वीकेंड्स. सो इट हैज़ अ वेरी पॉजिटिव वाइब. पीपल आर सो हैप्पी चैटरिंग अलोंग, क्योंकि यू नो इट्स समर्स एंड पीपल आर हैप्पी व्हेन इट्स समर्स हियर. दे जस्ट गो आउट and have fun. So I really enjoyed exploring these little streets. 2-3 ghante kahan chale gaye pata hi nahi chala. Next we visited the Bluebird Tea Company. It's a Willy Wonka style store for tea lovers. Using their tea mixology skills, they have created everything from peppermint creme and salt caramel flavor to ginger beer, mochi tea and chili kale. It's definitely worth a visit whether you are on the food tour or not. Brighton's spirit is colourful, but so are its walls. Street art and impressive murals cover parts of the city. If you want to see some of those, just head to Trafalgar Lane. Don't forget to binge on some delicious gelato and ice creams on your way to explore the city. I definitely had a great time tasting those flavours. The super amazing weather, colorful streets, and awesome people, they just made my first day warm and welcoming in Brighton. Our second day started with the beach side of the city. Just keep walking along the beach and the massive I-360 will be hard to miss. Designed by the same architects behind the London Eye, the British Airways I-360 is an exciting new addition to the seafront, and while the views from the top are impressive, the architecture of the structure itself is equally as photo worthy. Being a civil engineer, this intrigued me the most, and for those of you who are interested, there is a little shop after the tour where you get to see all the details on how it was built as well. Holding up to 200 people at a time, you enter the capsule at the bottom and then ascend to a height of 138 meters. The views from the top are breathtaking, you guys. You can spot all the major tourist attractions of Brighton from within the capsule and have a look at some hidden art as well. For lunch, we tried some Thai cuisine at Sabai Thai, which is greatly recommended by the locals in there. The next stop is the Brighton Pavilion, which looks more like a relative of Taj Mahal. This place is also nicknamed as Pleasure Palace because Prince George indulged in a lot of entertainment and parties here. It was great to see something that really symbolizes India here in England. The best part about this place is its greenery, where you can just lie down and relax and chill. People keep performing here and it serves as a very great spot to just rest for a while after a long day of touring. Our trip to Brighton would not have been complete without visiting the Pebble Beach. After enjoying my time in the beach, we headed towards the Brighton Pier. For all you non-vegetarian lovers, agar Brighton mein aaye aur fish and chips nahi khaya to kya khaya? So you'll get a lot of shops selling fish and chips. Do binge on that as well. You cannot miss out eating at the pier, enjoying some rides at the pier, and last but not the least, become kids all over again and enjoy the amazing casino.
And we end our second day in Brighton with a lot of fun in the casino. It's already 8:30, lag nahi raha hai, but 8:30 ho gaya. We'll just head over for dinner and then call it a day. Bye bye.
For day 3, our first stop had to be the colourful beach huts. These adorable beach huts run along the seafront from Brighton to Hove. Hove is a quieter city and is just a 15-minute walk from the Brighton city centre. Try to come here in the mornings when it is not very crowded, grab a cup of coffee in the nearby cafes, and yes, don't forget to click a picture or two in front of these iconic Brighton huts. And then we spent rest of our afternoon cycling along the streets of Brighton and going to Kemp Town, which is long associated with the LGBT culture and is famous for its pubs and restaurants. You can easily get cycles on hire in Brighton, but if you want to do something else, you can head to Devil's Dyke. It is just a bus ride from Brighton. It is a V-shaped valley and is very famous amongst hikers and trekkers, so you can spend your day there as well.
So guys, we finally come to the end of our trip to Brighton. It was an amazing trip. I had so many memories and moments in this trip to Brighton. I would definitely recommend you guys to check out Brighton, especially when you are in London, because it's just 1 hour away. If you are somebody who loves small streets, little cafes, vintage art, and if you are somebody who loves the lively environment and a lot of music, a lot of chilling, and especially the beach, then you must head out to Brighton. I would completely recommend that. And yes, I will see you soon in my next travel video. Till then, stay happy. Bye bye.